Good afternoon to all present here. I am Shobhana, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, Madhukar Kesari Jain College for Women, Valiyampady. Today I am going to discuss about in-depth blotting techniques. First of all, what is blotting? Blotting is a technique by which macromolecules such as a DNA, RNA, protein is resolved to the gel matrix. It is a powerful technique which allows the researcher to identify and characterize the specific molecules in a complex mixture of a related molecules. This technique is used for transferring in the DNA, RNA, proteins. And also onto a carrier so they can be separated and often follows the use of gel electrophoresis. Next one, the types of blotting techniques. They are divided into three types. First one is the southern blotting, northern blotting and western blotting. The southern blotting is used to detect the DNAs and northern blotting is used to detect the RNAs. Western blotting is used to detect the proteins. And next one, the blotting sheet. The blotting sheet is an important required material for the blotting techniques. This blotting sheet is used for Whatman papers. This Whatman paper is a 3 mm papers. This Whatman papers is used for the blotting techniques because of the high quality, purity and the consistency. Next one, this Whatman paper is used extensively in the electrophoresis for lifting of the sequencing gels. This is for the creating the sandwich. The sandwich, we name it as the sandwich because they are arranged in the some of layers similar to the sandwich. That's only we are using in the sandwich layers. So the sandwich consists of the filter paper, nitrocellulose membrane, gel matrix and another piece of filter paper. And next one we see that the southern blotting. Southern blotting is discovered by Sir Edwin Southern, is developed in the 1975. Next one, the southern blotting is used to detect the DNAs. This method involves in the separation, transfer, hybridization. Next one, this DNA can be the single gene. And next one is a part of larger piece of DNA, particularly in that viral genome. Next one, the southern blotting, the key to this method is the hybridization. Next one, hybridization. First of all, what is hybridization? The process of forming a double-stranded DNA molecules between a single-stranded probe and as a single-stranded target patient DNA. This is for the hybridization. Next one, what is the principle of southern DNA? The mixture of molecules is separated, immobilized on a matrix probe addition to the matrix to bind the molecules. And what is probe? Probe in molecules of biology, hybridization probe is a fragment of DNA or RNA of a variable length which can be radioactivity or the fluorescence. Fluorescence labeled. It can then be used in a DNA, RNA or protein samples to detect the presence of nucleotide substances that are complementary to the sequence of probe. Next one, the unbound probes are removing. The place where the probe is connected corresponds to the location of the immobilized target molecules. And next one, what are the steps are involved in the southern blotting. The steps are followed by, first one is that the DNA is digested using the restriction enzymes. And next one is that the DNA molecules are forming in the small fragments. Then the small fragments are applying in that gel electrophoresis. This gel electrophoresis is applying for the transfer to the membrane. And next one is the probing techniques are used in the southern blotting. And final one is the autoradiogram. These steps for the southern blottings. And next one, what is electrophoresis? Electrophoresis is a migration of charged particles towards the oppositely charged electrodes under the influence of the electrical field. The electrophoresis DNA are kept under the salt solution, which allows the absorption of DNA into the nitrocellulose filter. And this is for the common steps for the southern blotting. First one, the DNA applied to the gel. Next one, the fragmented DNAs are allowed to run by the electrophoresis. And third one is that the electrophoresis DNA are kept under the salt solution, allows the absorption of DNA into the nitrocellulose filter. And fourth one is that now the DNA gets transformed filter. And next one, the hybridization technique. And next one is that after the hybridization, the unbound probes are removing. Next one, the final steps is that we hybridize DNA or exposed to the autoradiography. Okay, so this is for the southern blottings. And next one is the applications. Southern blottings used in the gene discovery, mapping, evaluation, development studies, diagnostic, and then forensics. And next one we see the northern blottings. So northern blottings, the James Alvin and the George Stubb, both the scientists are discovered in the northern blottings. Next, the northern blotting is a technique for detection of specific RNA sequences. And next one, what are the steps are involved in the northern blotting? So these steps also is similar for the southern blotting. Okay, so northern blotting and southern blotting both are similar. Okay, so some of small difference only presented in the northern blotting and the southern blotting. Okay, and next one is the steps involved in the northern blotting. First one, the RNA isolation. And next one, loading of sample on the agarose gel. Okay, so in the southern blotting, we are using the electrophoresis gel. Now, the northern blotting is used for the agarose gel. Okay. And next one, the blotting on the nitrocellulose membrane. And next one, the labeling with probe. And next one is the washing to remove the unbound probe. And final one is the reduction of autoradiogram. So, this is for the basic steps of the northern blotting. Okay. So both the steps are very similar. So some of differences only the present. Okay, so in the southern blotting we are using in the DNA extraction, and northern blotting we are using in the RNA extraction. Okay, so that's only see that both are similar. Okay, and next one we see that we are taking the sample, and next one is the RNA extraction. Then we are applying in the electrophoresis. So this RNA is separated by the size. Okay, so they are presenting the various sizes of RNA molecules. Okay, so that's one is there. The RNA is separated by the size. Okay, and next one, this RNA will not transfer into the membrane. Okay, and next one, the RNA fixed to membrane with the UV ultraviolet rays or the heating. Okay, so these RNA molecules are fixed to the membrane with the ultraviolet rays and the heat. So next one, the membrane is hybridized with labeled probes. And next one, the visualization of the labeled RNA on the X-rays. Okay, so this is for the steps for the northern blotting. And the applications of northern blotting. Okay, so a standard for the direct study of gene expression at the level of mRNA. Next one, the detection of mRNA transcript size. Next one, the study of the RNA degradation. The study of RNA splicing can detect the alternatively spliced transcripts. Next one, the study of the RNA of life. Next one, the study of the IREAs. IREAs means internal ribosomal entry site, to remove the possibility of RNA digestion versus the second cis-on translations. Okay, so these are the applications for the northern blottings. And next one we see that the western blottings. So western blotting, Dr. Douglas Lack of the University of Arizona Schools of Medicine's Department of Microbiology and Immunology. Okay, so Dr. Douglas Lack is discovered in the western blotting. Okay, so this western blotting technique is used for the identifying the proteins. Okay, so a technique in which proteins are separated by the gel electrophoresis and transferred to a membrane sheet. A specific protein is identified through its reaction with a labeled antibody. Okay, so this way western protein to detect the proteins. Okay, so proteins means is the next one. What are the principles of blotting techniques? Okay, so these techniques works on the principle of the antigen and antibody relationship. Okay, so these techniques we are using in that antigen antibody relationship. Okay, so this is for the protein molecules. Okay, so these techniques works on the principle of antigen antibody relationship. And next one, prerequisite for the western blotting. Okay, so this technique we are using in the SDS phage. Okay, so SDS phage means sodium deoxyacetyl sulfate. Okay, so it's a detergent. Otherwise, SDS phage is a soap that can dissolve the hydrophobic molecules but also as a negative charge attached to it. Okay, so this SDS phage technique is a free request for the western blotting. Okay, so this technique is much better in the western blottings. And next one, what are the steps are involving in the western blotting? Okay, so the gel electrophoresis, membrane transfer, blocking. Okay, so these are the three techniques are used in the western blotting. Okay, so first one we see then the gel electrophoresis. The proteins are separated according to the size. Okay, so gel electrophoresis means the proteins are separated according to the size variations. Okay, and next one, the membrane transfer. Okay, so what is membrane transfer? Transferring to the nitrocellulose by applying the current. Okay, so this is for the membrane transfer. And a third one is the blocking, then to prevent the non-specific protein interaction between the membrane and the antibody proteins. Okay, so blocking means then to the prevent non-specific proteins. Okay, so these non-specific proteins interaction between the membrane and the antibody proteins. Okay, so these are the steps for the western blottings. Next one, the western blotting. Okay, so western blotting, SDS phage is important technique which has to be done for the western blotting. Okay, so first one we take the SDS phage, and next one, the electrophoresis DNA kept in a salt solution which allows the absorption of DNA into the nitrocellulose filter. Okay, and third one is that then the electrophoresis DNA are allowed to bind labeled antibody form which we can detect the desired antibody. Next one, the blocking in the western blotting. The blot is incubated with a generic protein such as the milk protein which binds to any remaining sticky places on the nitrocellulose. An antibody that is the specific for the protein of interest, that is for the primary antibody, that is called as the AB1, is added to the nitrocellulose sheet and react with the antigens. And third one is that only the band containing the protein of interest binding the antibodies, forming a layer of antibody molecules. Next one, the following several rinses for removal of non-specifically bound antibody 1 This antibody 1 antigen complex on the nitrocellulose sheet is incubated with a second antibody, which recognizes the primary antibody and binds it. And next one is then, antibody 2 is a radioactivity labeled or is covalently linked to a reporter enzyme, which allows to visualize the protein antibody 1 and antibody 2 complex. And next one, the application. Okay, so to identify the specific proteins, okay, so these Western blotting techniques is to identify the specific protein, and second one, to identify their matches, and next one, the confirmatory HIV test to detect the anti-HIV antibody in a human serum sample. Next one, the definitive test for the bovine spongiform encephalopathy, otherwise it is called as the BSE. This BSE is commonly referred to the mad cow disease. Okay, so mad cow disease means a brain tumor diseases. Okay, and next one, in especially for cattle. Okay, so this mad cow disease, it's affected for only in the cattle. Okay, and next one, the some forms of the Lyme disease testing also employ Western blottings. So this is for the protein gel, otherwise it is called as the SDH phage that has been stained with the commercial blue. And next one, the faster way to the Western blot. Okay, so they are using the two techniques. First one is the faster technique and next one is the slow technique. Okay, so the quick Western kit provides the universal detection reagent that can be combined with the primary antibody incubation step, eliminating the need for a secondary antibody incubation step. This kit works with a variety of primary antibodies. This reduces the overall time to complete the Western blot. And this is for the standard Western blotting and the quick Western blotting. Okay, so we are doing the both Western blotting. First one is the standard blotting and next one is the quick Western blotting. Okay, so the simple difference only present in the both the Western blotting. Okay, so standard Western blotting, we are using a double time washing, and quick Western, we are doing the only single time washing. Okay, so that is the difference. Thank you guys. Thank you one and all.